Dear colleagues, I'm grateful to organizing committee for invitation and for possibility to represent our research. Today I will talk about new hybrid nanocomposites for anti-tumor therapy. This work will be done in collaboration between chemists from Kyiv National Taras Shevchenko University and biologists from Institute of Experimental Pathology, Oncology and Radiobiology and Institute of Molecular Biology and Genetics of National Academy of Science of Ukraine. Cancer is the major problem now in the world, despite of all strong efforts, different scientists from field of physics, chemistry, and biology. But seems that nanomedicine is a promising approach for solving this problem. Last year, numerous polymers, water-soluble polymers, are used like nanocarriers or nanocontainers for drug delivery of high toxic drugs to tumor cells. But our experiment proved that branch water-soluble polymers are much more efficient. Why? Because they have more rigid structure, so they are more stable for some conformational transition, and the branch polymers have more higher local concentration of functional groups in local volume. So today my talk will consist of three parts. Unfortunately, I have only 15 minutes, so I very briefly will try to explain you each part. If you will have some more detailed questions, we can discuss that in couloirs. So the first part will be devoted to synthesis and characterization of branch star-like biocompatible water-soluble polymers, dextran graft polyacrylamide in non-ionic and anionic form, and also I will tell you at the end about new our copolymers, which consist of dextran co and graft poly and isopropyl acrylamide grafted chains. The next part will be devoted to in situ synthesis of hybrid nanosystems into branch polymer matrices. It will be I will tell you about characterization of these systems. And the next part, it will be the most interesting because this part deals with in vitro and in vivo examination of our systems for anti-tumor therapy. So now I very briefly explain you what kind of polymers we synthesize. We synthesize star-like polymers with dextran co of molecular weight 700,000 and with grafted polyacrylamide chains. We can write the amount of grafts, and it was shown that the structure of star molecules depend on the number of grafts and the compactness. This increase of number of grafts becomes more higher. So it means that we can vary the amount of functional groups in certain molecular volume. Also, we obtain polyelectrolyte by hydrolysis of our star-like polymers, and this polyelectrolyte, which are star-like, are very rigid, and namely our polyelectrolyte were the most efficient for encapsulation of anti-tumor drugs. We obtain nanosystems. We have made the in situ synthesis of gold and aurum nanoparticles in water solution of star-like copolymers. And I would like to say that these systems are much more stable in time than the same nanosystem synthesized in linear polyacrylamide or polyacrylic acid, for example. For example, in polyacrylic acid, it's impossible to synthesize stable system. Just after synthesis, we always obtain the precipitation. But if you synthesize acrylic polymer, the system is much more rigid, so these polymers better stabilize nano systems. Now, very popular green synthesis, if you would like to use these nanoparticles for biomedical application. We also use this way, and we try to synthesize nanoparticles using green reductant. For example, we use glucose, ascorbic acid, hydrogen, but then we characterize these nanosystems. You see that the polydispersity was very high, and the form of nanoparticles were also different. But for biomedical application, it's very important to obtain nanoparticles with precise size. It's precise should be, for example, for gold and for silver, between 5 and 20 nanometers. And also, it's better that nanoparticles have spherical form. So only by using reductant sodium borohydride, we obtain nanosystem with desirable size of nanoparticles, and these particles were spherical in shape. And I would like to say that the system was stable during, for example, 3-5 years from the beginning of synthesis. And now I would like to tell you about our experiments with biologists. First of all, we tested our polymer for bioactivity. It was proved that our copolymers are biocompatible and can be very easy be entrapped by a macrophage cell. The first our stage was to try to encapsulate cisplatin into polymer macromolecules. It is well known that cisplatin is a high toxic drug and now is used for anti-tumor therapy. And the results was very good. You see now the plot. And we could kill near 90% of tumor cells. Next step was to test this system in two kinds of tumor cells. It was leukemia cells and lymphoma cells line. We see that the results of also is good, so we could kill almost 80% of tumor cells, but of course the for lymphoma cells the result is worse than for leukemia cells. So, as explained by biologists, it deals with some specific penetration our nanosystem to tumor cells of various type. And the next step was to synthesize the hybrid nanosystems, because it is known that nanosilver also can have some anti-tumor efficiency. And the idea was to synthesize nanosystem and to incorporate into polymer molecules both particles, cisplatin and also nanosilver. But we were very surprised that we did not obtain synergetic effect. We obtained negative synergetic effect, and we could not understand why. So we continue to study this system and understood that if we synthesize in situ in polymer matrix only nanosievery, we have very good ZOL, and we have a big amount of nanoparticles with size 5 nanometers and nanoparticles between 10 and 20 nanometers. But if we add to this system cisplatin, we see drastic change in ZOLs. So you can see that we observe some aggregation process, so our nanoparticles of silver began to form agglomerate, and the most efficient result that we observe some visualization of polymers. So it means that if our system is so complicated, so if we incorporate in polymer matrix two components, cisplatin and silver, obviously we decrease the hydrophilicity of molecule. So if hydrophobicity of macromolecule increase, we observe some self-organizing effect in solution. Obviously such big object like a leaf of stem cannot penetrate the membrane of tumor cells. It explains why our effect was not so good as it was expected. But this system with nanosilver and cisplatin can be used for example, hyperthermia therapy, but now we only start to work in this field. Now, another part of my presentation, it deals with photodynamic therapy. Obviously, now it's very popular therapy because this therapy almost has no side effect. What is photodynamic therapy? It's the method that use photosynthesizer and light. Then photosynthesizer are exposed to a specific wavelength of light, usually it's a red laser. They produce scintillate oxygen, and this oxygen kill the tumor cells. We synthesize nanosystem for using for photodynamic therapy. We incorporate in our polymers nanoparticles of gold and also chlorine E6, it's a photosynthesizer. And you can see that our nanocomposite was very efficient in experiments for carcinoma Lewis. We could kill almost 95% of tumor cells. And also we have made the experiments not only in vitro, but continue to work in vivo, and the result was also good. And you can see these mice with carcinoma Lewis, and this is the mice after treatment with our nanocomposite. And now we continue to work in this direction, and the next idea was also to encapsulate in nano container not only chlorine E6, nano gold, and also some toxic drugs, for example, doxorubicin, but we only started this research. And what we are doing now? The next step is to synthesize new, more modern nanocontainer for drug delivery of high toxic drugs into tumor cells. We synthesize Stalico polymers, Dextran, Graft, PNIPAM. Why namely these polymers? Because it is well known that PNIPAM is polymers which have conformational transition in physiological temperature range. So at stage 2, stage 3 degree of centigrade, linear PNIPAM can remove some encapsulated hydrophilic drugs into blood. Now we know that if we synthesize star-like copolymers and we write the structure of graft of star-like copolymers, we can shift the conformational transition region until 3-4 degree of centigrade. So it's very promising way to obtain really very efficient new nanocarrier. Also now we know that if we synthesize in this polymer nanoparticles, for example, gold, the question was, what happened with the nanoparticles if this polymer in the region of conformational transition? So if you have some aggregation, it means that this system cannot be used for medical application. But now we know exactly that this system are reversible, and we have some swollen, we have some we have some shrink of polymers, but nanoparticles don't change their size. This demonstrates this process. And now I have no time to continue. I would like only to show you my collaborators, because it's a big work, and we characterize our polymers at the Institute Charles Chadron, a group of Professor Michel Ravizo, and you see the biologists who now works with us. But I would like a special attention now to show you Professor Nikolai Gamaleya. Unfortunately, he is not with us now, but this person was really at the beginning of photodynamic therapy, and we have worked with him a long time. So I think that many people here know this person.
Next May. So contact with me, you can find my email in the book of Excel.